the Psyche mission will be the first to visit a metal-rich asteroid. This metallic asteroid is named 16 Psyche. Both the asteroid and the mission share the name Psyche. So to avoid confusion, we're going to refer to the mission as Psyche and the asteroid as 16 Psyche.
Psyche's launch period opens at the end of 2023, and it will journey through the solar system until it arrives in 2029 at 16 Psyche,
which orbits the Sun between the orbits of Mars and Jupiter. And the spacecraft will orbit the asteroid for nearly 2 years, mapping its surface to determine the asteroid's composition, topography, gravitational field, and magnetism.
Why did we choose 16 Psyche? It's a unique asteroid because it appears to be the exposed nickel iron core of an early planet.
Very early in the solar system, little planets called planetesimals, the size of continents or big cities, formed, and they melted and their metal sank to the middle to form a core. And we think those were the very first metallic cores in our solar system. So when we chose the asteroid Psyche, we were choosing an asteroid that might tell us something about that very first generation of metal cores when the very first tiny planets got the same structure as the Earth.
Now let's look closer to our home planet Earth. I have planet Earth here, represented by this blue clay sphere. The Earth is covered in a silicate-rich surface, which is another way of saying that the crust is rocky, but not metallic. Scientists think that 16 Psyche lacks this rocky crust because of an enormous collision that stripped away its less dense exterior. The remains of 16 Psyche are therefore likely similar to the cores of earlier terrestrial planets. That would mean 16 Psyche would look something like this. By studying this metal-rich asteroid, we can learn more about other terrestrial planet metal cores, like Earth's.
There is so much that we do not know about 16 Psyche, and as a result, it's important that we outfit the Psyche spacecraft with a variety of instruments to allow us to learn all about the asteroid once we arrive.
Psyche is about 81 feet long by 24 feet wide, including its expansive solar panels. These solar panels are crucial, not only providing the spacecraft with power for instrumental operation, but also providing electricity for the Hall effect thrusters. This method of propulsion features very slow but consistent acceleration, with excellent fuel efficiency.
It actually uses a gas called xenon. Each atom, we cause it to be electrically charged, and then we shoot that electrically charged atom through a magnetic field. It turns out that if you push enough atoms through a magnetic field out the thruster, it actually pushes the spacecraft in the other direction.
The spacecraft is equipped with a multispectral imager, which is actually two cameras for redundancy. This is perhaps my favorite instrument and will provide high resolution imagery of the asteroid's surface and distinguish between metallic and silicate components, as well as provide scientists geologic, topographic, and compositional data.
Additional asteroid composition observations will be taken by the gamma ray and neutron spectrometer. Molten planetary cores usually produce magnetic fields, and even a solidified core will likely have remnant magnetism. Psyche's magnetometer is poised to search for a remnant magnetic field and hopefully provide some insight to 16 Psyche's formation.
So on the Psyche mission, we're testing a new technology, laser communications. It's called the Deep Space Optical Communications Instrument. And so the spacecraft is going to send laser communications to Earth, and Earth is going to receive them and send them back to the Psyche spacecraft while the Psyche spacecraft is about as far away as Mars from the Earth. So that's our test, and we really hope that it will work.
Psyche's exciting journey to a metal-rich asteroid will reveal many answers about 16 Psyche, and also surely uncover just as many new mysteries.
What are the biggest surprises that you think it will uncover?